Today we're going to discuss JavaScript operators. Firstly, what is an operator? An operator in programming is it helps us to perform a kind of operations on operands or data, and we usually have sometimes the left operand and the right operand, and then the operator will help us to perform on an operation between or on the both operands. And in JavaScript, you have seen different examples we have done before with assignment operator, where we assign a value to a variable. Like we created a variable called name, and then we assigned it a name of the person, I can do. And we created other variables where we also were able to assign values to them. And we did that using the assignment operator. And in JavaScript, we have different classes of operators that help us to assign values to variables, to make comparison between variables or operands, and do some kind of data manipulation on our operands. So we have the number one category called arithmetic operator. We have the next one called comparison operator. We have the next group, logical operators. We have the assignment operators, the conditional operators, and also have the ternary operators. And then we're also going to discuss type operators and possibly bitwise operators. So let's look at the first category of operators called arithmetic operators. Yeah, what is arithmetic operator? You know, normally in your arithmetic class, you will be able to do some mathematical operations on data. You have the addition operator, which is represented with a plus. The way it is in your normal mathematical classes is also how JavaScript represents the addition operator. So what does the addition operator do? It adds the left operand with the right and the right operand together. So in this case, what we are supposed to do, we can see something like this. Let's say we have A plus B. A is the left operand and B is our right operand. And then we have the next one, operation, which is for subtraction. Subtraction operator, what it does is subtract the right operand from the left operand. So in this case, we're going to have something like, so we're going to have A minus B. Okay, so B is going to be subtracted from A. A is the left operand and B is our right operand. And then if we come here, we also see that we have a multiplication operator which multiplies the value of the left operand and that of the right operand together. So in this case, we're going to see A is multiplied by B. And whatever the result is, we become a single value. And then we go to the next one. We also have the division operator, which helps us to divide the operand by on the left by the operand on the right. So here, what we have is A divided by B. Okay, and then we have also the next category called increment operator. Let's say we have plus plus, and what does this do? It's called increment operator. Increment operator. And what does this operator do? What it does is it increases the value of the operand by one. Okay, the value of the operand can be will be increased by one. And we have, for example, when we say A plus plus A, or we can also have A plus plus. Remember, this increment operator works on a single variable. It works on a single operand, and it can either be post or pre. It can be done before the variable or the operand or after the operand. So that is why we have the plus plus A or the A plus plus. The plus plus A is pre-increment. The increment is done before the variable and added to the variable. But we have another one called post increment, which is A plus plus. And that means we first of all have our operand and then we have the plus plus. And the way it happens is this one is going to add the one to the operand in the current line of code where we are writing it, while this one will add it in the next line. So we also have the sibling of this, which is called the decrement operator, and it's represented with double minus, and we call it a decrement operator. And what does this one help us do in programming? It helps us to reduces the value of the operand by one. while the other increases, the increment operator, the decrement operator reduces. And we also have the pre increment and the post increment, where we have a minus minus. Okay, then we have the next one called modulus operator. The modulus operator, what it does for us is it divides the left operand by the right operand and return the remainder. Okay, it divides the left operand with the right operand, or by the right operand, okay, and return the remainder to us. Unlike the division operator, which returns the value of the division, the modulus return the remainder of the division operation performed on the two operand. And now also we have the last one we will discuss here, which is called the exponential operator, and it's represented with double multiplication. You know, exponential operation is usually you multiply the operand by the exponential value. So in this case, what it does is, first of all, it's called exponential operator. Okay, and what am I doing? So the exponential operator will multiply our operand by the number of times of its exponential value. Okay, so what it does, I said, multiplies the operand by the number of times of the right operand. Okay, so the left operand here, the left operand here, by the number of times of the right operand. So for example, if we have a let's say we have a multiply exponential b, what we are going to have this is a times a times a until the we get to the value of b, okay, until the value of b, like 3. If a b is 3, so we're going to have a times a times a, 3 times a by 3 times, multiply itself up to 3 times, which assuming that the value of b is 3. So that is what the exponential operator does for us. Now we're going to see some real life examples on how this can be used in programming. So let's come down and say examples. Okay, all right, say examples on arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators. Okay, so let's say for the first one, addition, what do we have? Let's say a plus b. First of all, before we can do this, we have to declare our a and b. So let's say here, let a equals 5 and then b equals 3. Okay, so we've declared our two variables a and b, and now we are going to do an addition operator using the plus operator. So we say the addition operator is usually the plus symbol, so we use the plus here, and then we say now let's define another variable called c for our result. So let's say our c is equal a plus b. Okay, so now let's log our, in this case we know 3 plus 5 is supposed to be 8, result returns of 8. So let's console log our result here and see if we are going to get the value of a. So let's see, console log the value of c to be 8. So let's say c equals c. Okay, so I'm going to run our code now and see what the result will be in operator. So let's open operators with live server and we see what it will be. So let me close this. So we'll go to our dev 2 and say, and then look at our console. Let me bring this down. Okay, let me put it below. So let's look at our console now, and you will see the value of a of c is 8. Yes, so our answer is correct. Our c have been added with a and b have been added to get the result of c, which is 5 plus 3 has been added together to give us the value of c. So we come back to our code now and take the next one, the subtraction operators. So say subtract subtraction operator. Okay, so we know what that's how we do this. We say a minus b is going to minus the value of b from a and return the result for us. So let's say now c is equals a minus b. Yeah, what do we have now? So let's also log our c here. At this point, our c is supposed to be 5 minus 2, which is supposed to give us another value of 2. Okay, 5 minus 3, sorry. So 5 minus 3, you see that we have the next result to be 2. So let's say, instead of just c, say a minus b. And then let's say here also a plus b. Okay. So let's come back to the next one and say we are doing multiplication. And multiplication operator. All right. So how is it done? We say a multiplied by b. So what we do here now, we also say c is equals a multiplied by b. And then we save. If we also log our c here, you see that our result is no longer going to be 2. So let's see our result now. You see our result is 15. Why is it 15? Remember, 3 times 5 is 15. So at this point, a times b is 15. Remember, we are not changing the values of a, we are reassigning the values of our arithmetic operation to c. So our a remains 5, our b remains 3. And when we multiply 3 by 5, we see that our result is 15. That is what we are getting. So if we say here now, a multiplied by b is giving us 15. So let's take the next one, which is our division. So let's say our division operator. What does it do? It divides the value of the left operand by the right operand. So we have a divided by b. So let's see again, our c is equals a divided by b. So if we log our c now, you see that our c is going to be a different value, the result of dividing 5 by 3. So let's say a over b is equal to c. So let's look our console again and see. A over C is 1.66667, and see, it's a different result now. That is 5 divided by 3. So if we look at the next operator called the increment operator, so let's see increment operator. So let's see how do we do that in programming. You remember our syntax is either the operand plus plus or plus plus the operand. And we have the post increment and the pre increment. So let's see a plus plus. So let's see c is equals a plus plus. And then let's log our c. Okay, let's log our c and say here now a plus plus. So what is it? Our result. Let's look at our result. A plus plus is still worth 5. Why? Because I told you earlier, this post increment, we still retain the value is assigned. We still remain the value, retain the value of A. After assigning the value of the operand to the variable, then the operand will be increased by 1. Okay. So if we had used the other one called the increment operator, the post increment, sorry. So let's see here now, plus plus a, and then we write our code here, c equals plus plus a. Now this is going to be added to c before the next line of code. So if you look at our code, it's not okay. Now looking at our results with the pre-increment operator, you see that the a will be increased already in this line. At this line of the code, A is going to be increased and reassigned to C. But at this, we're using this kind of example post increment, A will be assigned to C before A will be increased. So the result of adding 1 to A will now be taking effect at this other line of code. And now remember what we are doing here, we are adding 1 to A in this line, with the increment. That means A now should have gotten 2 added to it. So if we log C now, A plus plus, what we are going to see is additional 2 on A. You remember our A is initially 5. Now adding 2 to it with the first line A plus plus and the next one plus plus A, we're going to see 5 as our result. So let's look at 7 at our result. So we see that 1 have been added to A at this level, making it 6, although what we have assigned to C is 5, which is the initial value of A. And then at this level, A is already 6, and then we are now adding 1 to A and reassign to C. That is why we have here is 5 and then here is 2. That is the difference between the pre-increment and the post-increment operators in JavaScript. So that is okay. Let's look at the next one, the modulus operator now. Okay, you know, I remember I told you the modulus operator is used to return the remainder of a division operation. Okay, division operation between a left operand and right operand. So in this case, let's see, UC is equals A modulus B. So our A is still our left operand, and C, B is our left operand. So what do we have here? What we are supposed to have here now is 5, which is the value of A, modulus 3. Yeah, modulus 3. Remember, when 5 is divided by 3, they're going to have 1, 1, remainder 2. So our result here is going to be 2, because the remainder of 5 divided by 3 is 2. So let's log our C again and see what we have. So here we're going to have A modulus B, and then we look at our console again and see our results. What do we have? A modulus B is 1. Oh, let me go back. I think I have, oh yeah, not 5. A modulus B. Okay, let's see what is the value of A. Oh yes. Oh my god, I'm mistaken now. Remember, let's go back to our A is 5, and then our B, where is our B? We did some operation on B. Okay, we did some operation on A plus plus here. Okay, then we have C A modulus B. Let's see, what do we have? C is equals A modulus B. Okay, let's look at our result. What are we having? We are having 1. What do we have? 1. Now I think this is wrong. I think this is wrong. Remember, at this point, the answer is correct. At this point, we have already added. Yeah, at this point, remember, we have already added 2 to A. So A is no longer 5. A at this level now, based on the plus plus, the increment, A is now 7. So with this, our results will be okay. So 7 modulus 3, which the remainder will be 1. Yeah, the result is okay. So that is 7 divided by 3 will be 2, 2, remainder 1. And that is why our modulus operation is giving us 1. So our result is correct. Okay, I was still looking at A to be 5, not considering the increment operation that have happened on A. Yeah, you know, what was the confusion here? Forgot that when you say C equals A plus plus, the operation is going to add A, 1 to A before assigning to, it's going to add 1 to A. So A itself at this level will be altered, it will be increased. Before talking about this assigning value to C, that is why we have A now is 7, and 7 modulus 3 is giving us 1. So let's look at the last one, which is the exponential operator. Exponential operator. Okay, I told you, the just like a normal of exponential operation in mathematics, what we do, A modulus A multiplied or exponent B. Remember, our A is now 7, and then what we now have, A is equal 7 here, and B is the equals 3. So what this means is A multiplied by A, which is 3 times and then which is supposed to be 7 times 7 times 7. Okay, let's look at it here now. Let's say C is equals A, yes, modulo exponent B. So let's log our result. You're going to see A, our result of exponent of A, okay, is, okay, let's look at it in our console now. A exponent B, what is our result? Okay, so let's look at our console again. You see what we are going to have. A exponent B is 343. Why is it 343? Let's look at this. What we are having here is 7. Okay, let me put the C here and then just a space and 7 times 7 times 7 again. What is 7 times 7 is 49, and then 49 times 7. You see the result is going to be that 343. Okay, you see what we have here. This is 343 and this is 343. What it means is either this expression A exponent B is equally the same thing with multiplying A by the number of times of B. That is why we have 7 times 7 times 7. And you see this is shorter. Using the exponent key is very helpful. Imagine where A B is 20. That means we could have been writing 7 times 7 times 7 times 7 until 20. But using the exponent operator, we'll just be able to solve that with just few keystrokes. Okay, that is all about assignment operator. We've been able to discuss all the arithmetic operators, the addition operator, the subtraction operator, multiplication, the division, the increment, decrement, modulus, and the exponential operator. These are the basic popular or the provided arithmetic operators that are available in JavaScript. And with these operators, you'll be able to perform both complex and simple operations on different kinds of operand in JavaScript. Remember, mostly arithmetic operators are used to perform operations on arithmetic numbers, on numerical values. But the addition operator, remember, the plus, can be used to perform an operation on string. So if we have a variable, let's define another variable. Let D equals, let's D equals programming, or let's just say coding, code, okay. Let's see D equals code. I'm omitting the equal sign, the assignment operator. And then we say, let E equals A plus D. We remember D is a string, A is a number. What is going to happen? What we are going to see is that A and D will be concatenated. So when arithmetic operator plus is used on a number and a string, or just on a string, a group of string, what it's going to do is to concatenate them together. Concatenation means join. It's going to join the string together. So if we log our E now, what we are going to see is something like 5 or 7. I think our A now is 7. So let's see A plus D. We're going to see, let's log our E now. We're going to see like 7 code. So let's see our console. You see 7 code. That is what we have here, 7 code, because 7, which is the value of A, has been concatenated or joined with the string code, which is the value of D. So this the addition operator, when used on a string, performs a concatenation operation instead of addition, because string cannot be added, but it can be concatenated together. This brings us to the end of arithmetic operations. All right, let's look at comparison operators. In programming, we also do comparison. We can equally compare the values of two operands or even their data type. So in JavaScript provides a group of operators that help us to compare two operands together. We have the first one using the double equal sign. And what does it do? It compares two operands without considering their types. So like it compares whether A and B are equal. So it compares whether A and B are equal. Now, how do we do this? The syntax is A equals B. If this is true, it's going to return true. Otherwise, it will return false. So if A is not equals B in value, it's going to return false. And then we have the second one using the triple equal sign. And what this does, it compares the value of two operands at the same time, their data type. So it will compare whether the operand on the left, A, and the operand on the right, B, are equal in both value and type. Both value and type. If they are not equal in value or in type, it will return false. But if they are both equal in value and type, it will return true. So, and the next one is not equal to. We use this negate sign, which is an exclamation mark with equal sign joined together to compare inequality of two operands. What we do here, we are actually literally saying that A is not equal to B. That's what we are saying here. And the syntax is A not equal to B. So if A is not equal to B in value, A is going to return true for us. But if A and B are equal, it will return false. And then we have the next one, which is the greater than. The greater than symbol returns true if the operand on the left, like our A, is greater than the operand on the right side of the expression, like our B. Otherwise, it will return false. So if A is greater than B, we are going to see the results of this expression to be true. And the next one is less than. We're still saying this helps us to compare whether the operand on the left is less than the operand on the right. If the operand on the left is less than that on the right, it will return true for us. But if it is not, it's going to return false. And then we also have the greater than or equal to. How do we join the? We create this comparison by putting greater than and equal to sign together. What JavaScript does with this for us is to check whether the operand on the left is greater than or is equal to the operand on the right. If the operand on the left is greater or equal to that on the right, it's going to return true for us. Otherwise, it will return false. The next one, which is the last, is the less than or equal to. This one is used to check if the operand on the left is less than or equal to the operand on the right. If that is true, it will return true for us. Otherwise, it will return false. So let's see with an example. Remember, our A now has become 7 and our B is 3. So let's just bring it here. A equals 7 and B is equals 3. Now what we are doing here now, A is equals B. And we are saying, okay, if A is equals B, this will return true for us. Otherwise, it's going to return false. So if we go to our console now, and we see that A equals B is returned for us. Look at the result here, which is false. And now if we come down again and use the other one, let's say console log. Yes, let's now use A and D. D is a string. Okay. A is equal to D. Okay, the reason we are using D is because we want to use the triple equal sign to compare both their data type and their value. So let's say A is equals D. Remember, D is string. So what we are going to put here is 7 to know that their values are the same. Their values are the same, but their data type are not the same. So if we log this now, what you will see is that the result of the expression will also be false. Though their values are the same, their data type are not the same. But if we come to the first one here and put D here, it will now return true for us because their values are the same. Although the data type of D is a string, but the value is 7. So that will return true for us. So when you want to compare both the data type and value, you use the triple equal sign. Otherwise, just want to compare the values, you use the two equal sign operator. And let's see also the next one, which is our not equal to. So let's come here and say another console.log. Okay, and you said A is not equals B. A does not equal B. So let's see the result. A not equal to B. Now remember, our A is 7, our B is 3. So actually, A is not equals to B. So this expression is supposed to return true for us. Okay, so let's see now the result. Yeah, A is not equals B, which is true because 7 is not equals 3. They are not the same. So let's come down again and look at the next one, which is the greater than operator. Let's say A is greater than B. We know that for truth, A is greater than B. And so we are going to use code to determine that A is greater than B. A is greater than B. So let's look at it here now and say A is greater. Okay, we're talking of greater is greater than B. So if we log this, we are going to see that on our console, A is actually greater than B because the result will be true because 7 is greater than 3. And then we look at the next one, which is less than, and say console.log. And say something like A is less than B. A is less than B. Oh, we know this is wrong. This is false because A is greater than B. So A cannot be less than B again. So this is supposed to return false for us. So let's see. A is less than B. And let's look at the console again. A is false because 7 is not less than 3. So let's look at the next one, which is... Okay, the greater than or equal to sign. All right, so let's say A is greater than or equals B. And then let's look at it again. Say A is greater than or equals B. We know that A is greater than B, so this is going to be true. If we see our console, we look at it, A is greater than B. And then when you come down, let's say B is going to be 3. Okay, let's come here and say A is equals 3 because we want A and B to be equal and still check our A greater or equals to B in our console. So let's look at it. The last console value, we see A is greater than or equals B is still true because both A and B are equal. So this expression compares, check whether A is that greater or equals B. If one of the condition is true, it will return true. So there is the same thing with the last one, which is for less than or equals. So let's come here and say A is less than or equals B. So A now is still 7 because I've canceled or commented A equals 3. And then let's check the value again and say A is less than or equals B. So let's check our console and see the result of the code. So let's see, A is less than B. You see what we are seeing here is that the value is true. A is less than or equals B. The result is true. Let's see what is true. This is supposed to be false. So where is A equals B? Okay, we see here the result is false. A less than or equals B is false because A is 7 and B is 3. So this is all about the comparison operator. We use it to compare the value of two operands. Either they are equal or they are one is greater than the other. Mostly, we do this with numerical values in our code to check if the value are the same, but we can equally use some of these operators like this to check other kinds of data type if they have the same value. So you see here, I'm comparing hello and hello, saying hello is equals hello. We know that their value are the same. So if we check our console, we are going to see true as the result because hello, hello are the same in value, the same data type and the same value. So we see we can also use this to compare string if they are equal in value. All right, we have come to the end of our comparison operators, and we are going to look at the next operator in line, which is our logical operators. So next, we discuss logical operators. All right, let's now look at logical operators. Logical operators help us to compare two different conditions, or to combine two different conditions. Now, our comparison operator helps us to compare value, but in a situation where we want to do different kinds of comparison together, we will need to use the logical operators to join these various comparison in order to have to unify them as a single comparison and have a result which will be unique and which we can use to make decision. For example, if we want to perform an operation, if A is equals D and A is, let's say, is not equals 5, we can combine these two conditions using logical operators in our code. Okay, let's say, for instance, we know our example, we have our A defined, which is like 5. We have our A, which we assign the value of 5, and in the course of our code, let's just reassign them again. A, let's say A is equals 10 now, and then our B is equals 5. Okay. Now, if we want to combine two conditions together and say something like A not equals B, A is not equals B, we know this is true, and then we can use AND, the AND operator, we use the AND operator to combine another expression saying A is less than B. Okay, we can then say A less than B. All right. So if we consolidate this also, we'll see the result. Okay, let's have AND. Okay. All right, let's save this. So what we're saying is A is not equals B and A is less than B. So let's look at our console and look at the result. AND is false. You see, what we are having is false. These two operations, if we use only this, A is not equals B, our A is 5. Okay? Our A is not equals B. This is true. Okay? This left side of the multiple comparison is true. A is not equals B. But on the other side, we say A is less than B, which is false. Now, when remember what we say here, the condition will return true if only the conditions, the comparisons at the both sides are true. If one of them is false, the result of the expression will be false. This is not a single expression as a comparison. We are not just combining two multiple comparison statements in order to get a single result. So now we are only having false, because one, if we wrote this separately, we could have this one will be true, this one will be false. But because we are combining them using the logical operator, and the situation is both of them must be true before this expression will return to true. If we turn this to greater than, we know that A is greater than B, our result will not be true, because A is greater than B, or the other one, and this one also, A is not equals B. This is true, and this is true, and then therefore our result will be true. But if either of them is false, the result of AND of logical operator will result to false, because both of them must be true before it returns true. Okay, let's look at the next one using the OR operator. Now, using the same example, let's repeat this. Let's just pick this again and say, if A is not equals B, or A is less than B. Remember, all will give us true if just one condition is true. So if we look at our console here, what we are going to see is that the last one is true, because one of the conditions is true. So we see the result of our expression here is true. Okay, so let's look at our code. This result is true. Why is it true? Because one of the condition is true. So in a logical operator, where the OR operator is used, so long one of the condition, one of the comparison is true, the result will be true because it's just looking for one to be true. So either this is true or this is true, then it will be true. But if both of them are false, it will return false. But if both of them are true, it will still return true. So if we still come here and say A is greater than B, we know that this is true because 10 is greater than 5. So this is true and this is true. OR operator is going to return true. So we see here OR is also returning true for us because both of them are true. So in the logical operator OR, we return true if one of them, just one, is true. It's also true if both of them are true, but it's false if both of them are false. So we look at the last one, which is the OR, the NOT operator. Now let's see, look at here. This, we're already using it here with this sign, but this is not exactly how we need to use this. So we look at the OR NOT operator. What does it do? It reverses the Boolean result of the operand. So in a situation where we have this, so if we want to reverse the result of this, we remember this is true, and then we want to reverse this and say if this is not true. So once we put the NOT operator here, you know, remember we also say NOT equal to, that is what we are doing here. But now using the NOT logical operator alone with an expression like this is going to reverse the result to the opposite. So if it is true, the result will not be false. So let's just pick this and form a new line, then we'll leave this the way it is. So let's see the NOT operator in action here. So NOT operator, and let's now look at our result. The NOT operator here now is giving us the value of all right. So the NOT operator here is giving us the value of false because let's look at it again. This expression is returning true. If you look at the one on the top, the previous one here is returning true for us. So, but we are now reversing it. So if this is true, the inverse of it, the NOT, is going to be false. So that is what the NOT operator helps us to achieve. As we continue building our code from next week, solving problems, we will see practical applications of these operators in our code. So this week, we have been able to go through these operators, and we'll also look at other operators that we have in our list. So let's look at the next one we have in our list, which is, let me go back to the top and look at the next one, which is assignment operators. Now we know we have been doing assignment, but we had just did one type of assignment using the equal sign. So let's look at this now, assignment operator. Okay, there are different kinds of operators that fall under this assignment. And we have the first one, which is just the equal sign, which assigns the value on the right, you know, to the operand on the left. It assigns the operand on the right to the one on the left. Okay, that is what it does. So in our case here, we have been doing this. You see, A equals B, it is assigning the value of 10 to A. That is exactly what that does. And we look at the next one, which we haven't seen before in our code, but we are going to be seeing subsequently in practical as we solve problems. So we look at this, we sum up the left operand with the right operand and reassign the value to the left operand. So this is it, sums the right the left operand with sums the right left operand and the right operand and reassign. No, reassign is a very important thing here. Reassign the result to the left operand. That is what it does. And then we also have this one and equal to together. You remember we have been doing compound operation here, just like we did with the greater than equal to. In terms of assignment, it's similar. You are performing two things at the same time. So what this does is subtract the right operand, you know, from the left and reassign. That is an important thing here. Reassign the result to the left operand. Okay. And we have the next one, which is multiplication and assignment together. It's just the same thing. It multiplies, you know, we just copy this. Yeah, it multiplies the left operand. So here we have multiply. Okay. So multiplies the right operand, the left operand, and the right operand, you know, and reassign the value to the left operand. So it multiplies the left operand and the right operand and reassign the result to the left operand. And we also have the one, the division and assignment together, which is put division sign, you put assignment together. And what does it do? It divides, you know, divides the left operand by the right operand and reassign the results to the left operand. That's exactly what it does. And now we also have the last one, which is modulus and assignment together. So we have modulus assignment together. And what does this do? It's divides the left operand, you know, with by the right operand and reassign. Remember, modulus usually deals with remainder, you know, so it will reassign the remainder, not the result of the division, the remainder to the left operand. So modulus doesn't consider the remainders in the division results. It just returns the whole number, and the remainder is the modulus value, and that is what it reassigns to the left operand. So let's look at these examples of this as we continue. So let's look at the first one. We have been doing this now. We can say let x, no, let's declare a variable s, let x equals a plus b. We know this is an assignment. Though we are having an expression at the right, we can assign an expression to a variable. We can also just assign a value like 40. So when we do this, we are doing an assignment. X is not going to hold the value of 40. So if we assign an expression like a plus b, what is going to happen? JavaScript is first going to add these two values together and reassign the value to x. Then we look at the next example, which is our compound assignment with the sum and the assignment together. So let's look at this. Now we say s, remember s is not for the value of this, so let's just give it a whole number, a value. S is 40. So and we know our a, b here is 5 and our a is 10. So let's say s is equals to s plus equals a. You remember a is 10. So what are we going to have? The result of this expression is going to be 50. If we console log x is going to become 40 plus 50, because what this means is a s is equals x plus a. That is what it means, because it sums the left operand, which is s, and the right operand, which is a, and reassign the result to s. So if we console log s now, let's console log and see the value of s. We see x is equals it is. So let's look at our console and see the value of s. So when we look at our console now, you see that the value of s is 50, because we have added x to A, or we have added A to S, and A is then X initially was 40, now S is 50. Okay. Okay, let's look at the next one, the minus and equal operator, which help us to subtract what is on the right from what is on the left and reassign the result to what is on the left. Okay, so let's see. X minus equals A. Okay, so what does this mean? What it means is S is equals X minus A. And let's look at the result. If we log S at this point, if we log S now at this point, let's just give it a different notation, a different symbol here, S minus equals A. Okay, so let's differentiate it now and look at our console. What are we going to see? We're going to see back S is going to return back to 40. Why? Because the value of A has been removed again from S. Okay, now let me comment this and reduce the things I have on my console. Okay, so we see S minus equals A is 40. At this point it's 50 because we added 10. Now we remove the 10 and S is now 40 again. So this is equivalent to writing this, and you see this is actually a shorthand. It's just a shorthand of adding the values on the left, the left operand with the right operand, and reassign the value to the left operand. Then we have the next one in our list, which is the multiplication and assignment together. So we see multiplication sign and assignment equals A. So in this case, what this also means is S is equals S multiplied by A. So if we take the value of S now is 40 and A is 10, so it's actually going to be something like 40 times 10. So let's see what it gives us now. If we log our result now and say S multiplied by A, what is it going to give us? If you look at it, it's supposed to give us something like 400. Yeah, we see we have 400 because we have multiplied S by A. So we look at the next one, which is division, and S is now equals divide S by A. And what are we going to see? This also means S is equals X divided by A. And this is equivalent to 400 divided by 10 because now our S is 400. So the result, if we look here, what we are going to see is S over A is supposed to, S over A equals A, S over A equals A is also going to give us something like 40 because we've divided 400 by 10. So if we look at our console now, our S is now 40. So if we look at the next one, which is the modulus operator, it's still going to give us something similar. If we say S modulus and A equals A, what this also means for us is that S is equals X modulus A. And it also means 40 modulus 10. Okay, so let's see our result again, and you see that the remainder is what is going to be assigned. If 40 is divided by 10, our remainder will be 0. So we see this now to be 0. Our S is now 0. So let's see our result. You see our remainder is 0. See, this is all about the assignment operator in the from the simple assignment to multiple operation with as plus and assignment together, and subtraction and assignment together, multiplication, division, and assignment together. Okay, so we look at the next operator, which is our ternary operator. So what is a ternary operator? Ternary operator is a special kind of operator in JavaScript that help us to do an if statement in a single line of code. Ternary operator. So that is what ternary operator help us to do. It help us to write a single, to write an if statement in a single line of code. Just a same a shorthand of an if s statement. Okay, so let's write an if s statement in a short form. So is a shorthand of if s statement. Okay, so what is the syntax? The syntax is you have the condition. Okay, you have the condition here, and then you have the question mark. The question mark is asking, is the condition true or false? If it is true, assign value one to the operand on the left. Otherwise, assign value two. Okay. Otherwise, use the column for the otherwise case if it is false. So you assign value two. Okay. So this is how ternary operators is done in JavaScript. If condition on the left is true, if this condition is true, assign the value in this first location to the operand on the left, otherwise assign value two. So if we look at our code now, we can say this condition, let's pick one of the conditions we've been using, and let's just say if A is less than B, okay? Let's just use this, and then, so let's say S, we'll use our S again. If S equals A is less than B, you remove this, it's not needed. A is less than B, is it true? If it is true, then let's reassign a different value to X. Okay, let's use a different variable here. So we use a string. So let's just say let Y equals, okay, if it is true, so we can write the statement here and say A is less than B. Otherwise, if it is not true, so we can say, we know that B is less than A, or we can just say A is greater than B. So what this means, if A is less than B, we'll have this result assigned to Y. Otherwise, if A is greater than B, we'll have this result assigned to Y. So the value of our I depends on the result of this condition here. Okay, so let's log our Y now. So let's say console.log Y. So let's say Y, the value of Y now. Okay, so we'll see in our console now, what is the result of this? Our Y is going to depend on whether A is less than B or not. So let's see, A is greater than B, because Y, let's look at our code again. What is the value of A and B? We define here A is 10 and B is 5. That means A is greater than B. And we look at our console. What is it telling us? We are saying A is greater than B, because A is not less than B. This condition is false. Therefore, this is the less value, the value 2, that is going to be given to Y. So that is how ternary operator works. We use it to write an if statement. This could have been written with an if statement, which is in this form. Let's say if A is less than B. Okay, so let's define our Y on the top here. Let me create a different variable, say message, okay? Message, let message, it doesn't have a value now. So if A is less than B, our message should be A is less than B, okay? And then we have the next line, we have our S, and then we say, if A is not less than B, so we have a message, our message value should be equals A is greater than B. So if we log our message also, let's log our message along with our Y, we see that we have the same value. So let's say console.log message, and then we have our message here. So if we look at our console now, we're going to see messages A is greater than B, and our Y, so A is greater than B, because both of them are doing the same thing. But when you look at the code, you find out that this syntax with the ternary operator is very straightforward and simple, and is easier to understand also, but it's actually representing this whole statement of 4 to 5 lines of code. So you just write the whole thing in a single line, and your ternary operator is going to do the comparison and assign appropriate value to the variable. That is it about ternary operator. We also have the next type of operator we'll discuss, which is the type operator. We've seen this in our earlier classes where we have to check the data type of a variable. So if we come here and say type of message, you know, our message is string because the value of this message is string. So if we say type of message is string, so if we log this, we see that it's going to tell us the data type of the variable message. So the type operator have two value. One of them is type of operator. So let's say type of message. And then we have this. And if we log this on our console, we're going to see the type of message is string. JavaScript has evaluated the message variable and returned the data type for us. If we put B here, type of B, and you find that it will be number because our B was declared and a number value was assigned to it. So if you look, type of B is number. So the type operator is helpful in helping us to find the data type of a variable. Okay, and there are two types, the type of and the instance of. The type of operator and the instance of. The instance of is used for an object to know if this variable is an instance or belongs to this particular object class. So we have come to the end of our operators in JavaScript class. Next, we are going to consider if statement and switch statement. And afterward, we'll consider arrays in JavaScript and array functions. And after that, we are going to spend some couple of days in solving JavaScript related problems and familiarize ourselves with the principles and the syntax we have learned thus far, so that we'll be able to master them and know applicable areas we'll be able to use them in our software development career. Thank you for being part of our class today.